What's up, everyone? My name is Dora. Welcome to my channel. Today, I'm going to show you how to make foaming soap tablets or foaming soap pills, which are concentrated soap tablets that create foaming hand soap. The foam created is so thick and luxurious. These tablets actually create better hand soap than my original recipe. One of you guys requested this tutorial, so I researched online and found a recipe that was published by the Stepan company promoting their powder surfactant bioterge. I tried several recipes and their recipe amounts performed the best, so I'll be using an adapted version. Let's take a look at their recipe. First, I find the percentages here a bit over the top, as in it's not necessary to be this technical, which even if I wanted to, I couldn't because my scales don't register three numbers after the decimal. Now, you can absolutely strictly follow recipes like this to a T, but you don't have to. I look at recipes as more of a suggestion anyways, but my point is it doesn't matter if I use this recipe or the one that I'm about to give you, both products come out the exact same. And while I appreciate this recipe featuring bioterge, there are far superior powder surfactants that create richer, thicker foam like SLS, SLSA, or SES. For more information on powder surfactants, click the information icon. As always, check out the description for helpful information like the recipe, tips, updates, the supply list, and more. Sodium carbonate is used to break down dirt and oil. It's not the same thing as baking soda, but you can use either one. Watch until the end to find out how to make your own. Citric acid allows the tablet to dissolve more quickly and efficiently. The powder surfactant creates foam and lather. Tetrasodium EDTA maintains clarity, prevents rancidity, promotes effectiveness of other ingredients like the preservative, and improves foam and lather. The liquid surfactant is a binder and it also boosts foam. The preservative is crucial as this tablet will eventually be sitting in water. Sieve dry ingredients together and mix wet ingredients separately. Add the wet ingredients slowly while whisking. Thoroughly mix, knead, and rub the mixture with your hands. It's quicker to use multiple molds in one, like an in-bed maker. Chunk of Dust has several to choose from, which will be linked in the description. Just make sure that the tablets fit in the bottle. Start with the bottom plate on. Fill each cavity all the way. Then smush the top plate down really hard. I stand on mine. Take the top and bottom plates off and gently push the tablets out. Dry them for 24 hours. Store them in an airtight container or bag. I got these cute little jars from Temu. Fill the bottle with warm water and add a tablet. Allow the tablet to fully dissolve, which can take up to 20 minutes.
So after the tablet dissolves, there's not gonna be anything left. It's gonna be completely clear. Like, this has been sitting for 24 hours and it's completely clear and there's no lines of anything separating. This is absolutely a fantastic recipe. Look at this. It's just perfect.
Keep in mind that I only added one tablet. One tablet creates this thick, rich, dense, luxurious foam. This is that good foam too, that goes on forever and somehow magically seems to just keep producing more and you don't even know where it's coming from, but it just keeps, it's insane. I wanted to see what it did in a loofah and wow, like just wow. It produces so much foam. The foam isn't light, fluffy, and airy either. It's more like thick, rich, and heavy. Like it's hefty. It has weight to it. It's quite simple to turn sodium bicarbonate or baking soda into sodium carbonate, also known as washing powder or soda ash. Line a baking sheet with foil. Spread the baking soda in a thin, even layer. Bake it at 400 degrees Fahrenheit. While baking, the baking soda releases water and carbon dioxide, which leaves you with just dry sodium carbonate. Keep baking until the weight is reduced to 2/3 or 66.666% of the original weight. So for instance, this was 300 grams of baking soda that turned into 200 grams of washing soda after baking it for roughly 45 minutes. After it cools, store it in an airtight container so it will keep indefinitely. All right, guys, thanks so much for joining me. For more awesome tutorials just like this one, subscribe now. All you have to do is click my face right there in the middle.